So to that point, obviously a lot of Arizonans are out of work right now. So we would like to do our part in helping you get that gig.
Yeah, with our Get That Gig job search program, we're connecting you with businesses that are hiring right now here in the state of Arizona. So Gina, break this down. How does this work?
Well, let me take you to our website because it is really easy, actually. Thank you so much, actually, for pulling that up. So if you go to the coronavirus section, there's another section that we have here that you can click on. It's called The Way Back, and it's got a lot of information about schools, but also jobs. And if you take a close look, you can see that big section there. We are hiring. You click on that. And with our partners from Asurion, look at all of the job listings that are in one place for you. And there are websites that are right there along with those job listings. You can not only see who's hiring, what the positions they're hiring for, and then again, you can go right to their websites. Now, this morning, we know more than 470,000 Arizona residents have filed for unemployment since COVID-19 hit its peak earlier this year. That's nearly 15% of our entire state. So we want to help out. Again, you can go to our website, azfamily.com, and get to The Way Back, and then you will see where those job listings are. So not only do we want to connect you with the actual job listings, we want to help you make sure that you're prepared to apply and for the interview so you really can get that gig. So joining us now is the CEO of a company called LearnKey, Jeff Coronucci. Help me, Jeff. Pronounce your last name for me. Good morning to you.
It's Coronucci.
Coronucci. Thank you, my friend. I really appreciate it. I might not be able to pronounce your last name, but you know what? I can ask you some good questions because you've got a lot of great advice. I know you guys have got a couple of online courses to help people with the job search. And because you've got so much information, let's jump right in here. I want to first ask you about resumes because, you know, HR people get a pile of resumes. How do you really make yours stand out? I mean, you know, do you put an emoji? I mean, what is it that's going to make your resume stand out?
Well, what's going to be really important right now is that it's relevant, that it's updated, that it's very specific. A lot of people don't pay attention right now to the job that they're applying to, for example. So if the job is looking for skills with Microsoft, then you better make sure that you're highlighting those skills and making sure that it's relevant to the job that's being posted because everything's being done online right now.
So let's say you were maybe in the hospitality industry and you're looking at something completely different. You know, how would you cater that on your resume to make you relevant to that specific company? What would you suggest?
That's a great question. And there's a couple of ways to do that. First of all, there's always skill versus will. Some people may not have the skill, but they have the willingness. They're going to be persistent. They're going to demonstrate, I don't have this skill, but maybe I've taken some online courses. Maybe I've gotten certified, showing the willingness that you want to learn. As a matter of fact, we hired somebody recently that didn't have a skill, but she had the willingness and we paid for her to get that skill. And then we hired her.
Awesome. Diligence, persistence. You know, you also say creating your personal brand. What does that mean exactly?
That's a very good question. A lot of people, and I hate to say this, but younger people are not really paying attention to their online presence. And that is very, very key. Just remember, whatever you're putting out there on Facebook, on Instagram, you want to make sure that those things are not going to embarrass you in an interview or reflect not who you really are. And it's really important, and people don't pay attention to those things. They don't understand that once you filed your resume, people are going to be looking at and looking how you present yourself online.
You know, Jeff, let's talk about navigating the online job search. You know, here at AZ Family, we've tried to put everything in one place for people, but it can be overwhelming. I mean, really, how do you narrow it down so that you're not just, you know, or should you cast a wide net?
Well, I think it's really important that you learn some of the basic fundamentals of how to find jobs online, which is why that's one of the courses that we're actually offering to Arizonans that are unemployed at no cost. It's not easy. You're absolutely right. There's a forum like LinkedIn. There are different types of forums where you can present your information, but I think right now it's very, very competitive. It was competitive before the pandemic. And think about the fact now afterwards and the same issues, some of the simple communication skills, how to practice, how to dress properly, even when you're on video like this. These are all things that are very, very important.
And then very quickly, because we are really out of time, we have to talk about social media because it is the one place where you have a reach. So if you could give us one quick piece of advice, one tip on how to best use social media for the job search, what would that tip be?
That tip would be, first of all, to make sure that you learn some type of technology skill.
Okay.
And achieve that skill, and then socialize with folks that you have that skill, as well as start to build your network and make sure that you're sharing with people the skills you have and the types of jobs that you're looking for that you think you're qualified for.
Great advice. Jeff Coricini, I got it this time, from LearnKey. I really appreciate your time this morning, and we'll put the information on our website about the two online courses that you're offering free to everybody. Thank you, sir.
You're very welcome, and they are no charge, and we want people to take advantage of that.
Fair enough. Thank you.